Hey, what's up, YouTube? This is HellBuddy. This video is talking about the Belkin virus security. After we set your new Wi-Fi network and password, the next thing you need to do is enhance your network security protection. What's that mean? You know what? That's very easy to have someone's default router IP address while people try to Google it. Once they hit your router setting page, but there's no password needed. It's very terrible because they can do any change without your permission. Somehow, at least you have to limit the permission who can use your network and set up a login password to prevent the person access your administrator without your permission. So please lock the door first. Don't leave it blank again. Select the system setting that will go to utilities page. It's a very important part. You have to set up a new login password to access your administrator. The first field, type in the current one. If you don't have either, leave it blank, and then type a new password. Repeat type again to make it confirm. So now let me create a new one and repeat type in again. The below setting is about login timeout, from 1 minute to 99 minutes. You better set as short as well. Now I'm setting to 1 minute. Why? If you hold for your login status too long, that's a very dangerous moment because you don't know what's happening. Who came to check around on your PC? When you forget to log out your computer, hang out to somewhere, even just for a while. Set the login timeout when the section expires, and then click Apply Changes. It takes 10 seconds to complete process. You see now, out of the login page, same happens for this after the time expires. It would auto-log out again, but this time when I hit submit, it won't allow me to log in because the field is blank. I need to enter a password which I created before, and then click submit. You can make your SSID nearly invisible for increasing your network security. Go to Channel and SSID, uncheck the box at Broadcast SSID to make your SSID invisible on the network. And then click Apply Changes. It takes 60 seconds for complete the changing. I can see my SSID on net with my admin device. In fact, it's increased security, but not exactly to make you safe in the network for taking this action. Somehow it's pretty complicated to get other devices as your iPhone, iPad, to the invisible network, so I can't find my Wi-Fi network, especially if you will not only have one device. So I check it to visible. Now I see my network, and we probably need to go to the next option. How to check out who are using your Wi-Fi network? Select the HCP client list. This page shows you the list of the devices which around you connect to your network. And then click Refresh tab to see the details. You can see each device has physical MAC address individually. Now I have three devices connect with my router, my MacBook, iPad, and my cell phone. Let me show you how it works. Go to MAC address filtering. Enter the MAC address which on the list. Check the box of enable MAC address filtering. This is my MAC address has already in the filter. That means this device only on the list to allow access my network. The others are not, which means I've kicked them out of the list. They are unable to access my Wi-Fi network without my permission. Click Apply Changes to take 5 seconds done the process. Now my Mac is still on the internet, but my iPad and cell phone, they both took a long time to get on the internet. Finally, at the end, they are unable to access on the internet. If now I want to give the permission to my iPad, let me go back the HCP client list to write down my iPad 12 digits numbers of the MAC address, and then add it on the MAC address filtering list, and then click Add tab. Click Apply Changes to take the other 5 seconds complete. Check my iPad guest back on the internet now. It's different between of setting a guest password. The MAC address filter is much more efficient to kick someone out of the network. Go back to the HCP client list. Those are the device IP addresses. Each connects with my MAC address. 192.168.2.3 is connecting with my MacBook. And then go to Select System Settings. scroll down to the third row, Remote Management. Before doing this step, please make sure you set your administrator password. Check the Enable Radio button to access Remote Management Enabled. Check the box of any IP address can remotely manage on the router to allow any device access to your admin. Now I'm unchecked not to allow anyone access, and choose the only this IP address to manage the router. Now I put the map IP address 192.168.2.3 in the field, and then keep 8080 ports to the remote access. Click Apply Changes. This is the reminder to tell me make sure set the admin password if I didn't have set yet. Click OK to wait 10 seconds, complete process. Now my MacBook is available, connect to my router setting page, but my iPad and cell phone, they both get on the router setting page. When I try to log in and enter the password, they both unable to log in and got the message of duplicate administrator. This device is managed by the IP address 192.168.2.3. That's my map IP address. Same result if you check the disable button to disable remote control. That way to set your default device IP to be the manager, which the device was the initial to set your router. It can efficiently control your provision of login administrator, but you must use a specified device instead of using the other devices to access the router admin. The last thing is everyone concerns, password. You can choose the security mode to be WPA2 and the authentication to be more comprehensive one to increase the password encryption. However, it still not guarantees you are safe and will not be hacked. The point is what the password you created, not just only dependent about the password encryption. Try don't make too simple as you can, like someone's name, birthday, or any works or face to get someone easy guess it. The password allows you to use letters, numbers, space, and symbols, and you are better to make it at least 8 characters long or as long as well. So why don't use it? I know it maybe makes you hard to remember, but consider the network safe. Other than all the settings, you have got to restart the router. Click Restart Router to refresh your router, and then click OK. It will take like 60 seconds to complete the process. Thanks for watching and please subscribe to HellBuddy channel.